We begin our series today focusing on the life of Joseph. Our series is called The Dreamer, Joseph's Life of Faith. We're going to start in Genesis chapter 37. I would like you to pause this video or audio and read verses 1 through 11 of Genesis 37. Go ahead, you can do that now. This is where the adventure of Joseph's life begins. As you read this, did you notice how out of control this family was? They had troubles. There were four signs of trouble in Jacob's family. Our first sign is found in verse 2, which is that Joseph was a tattletale. Shepherds have a lot of responsibility, and they have plenty of free time. With all this free time, Joseph's brothers gave up on being model citizens. We are not told what they did wrong. We just know that Joseph told on them when they got home. One thing I do know, being a tattletale almost never sits well with those on the other side. The second sign of trouble was Jacob playing favorites. Families are supposed to be places of unconditional love. And the problem here was that Jacob did not love all his children unconditionally. It was totally wrong to have a favorite family member. Our third sign was that Joseph announced his superiority to the family. In his first dream, he saw sheaves, which are bales of grain, bowing down to him. Then he dreamed that the sun, the moon, and 11 stars, which represented his whole family, bowed down to him. His entire family knew what this meant, and they certainly did not like that. The final sign that we see is that his brothers did not confront the sin in their hearts. Several times through this passage, we read that his brothers hated him and that they were jealous of him. Both are heart level sins. Listen to this verse in Matthew 15, verse 18. But what comes out of the mouth proceeds from the heart. It is obvious that God is seriously concerned about our hearts. Our hearts are the source of sin. People see the outside appearance, but God looks at the heart. Next, we see that Joseph was sent to check on his brothers. Somewhere on this long trek, things went from bad to worse. His brothers hatched a plan to kill him. However, Reuben convinced them just to throw Joseph into an old dry well. They took his coat and covered it in blood, so that they could convince their father that Joseph had been killed. Finally, we read that they sold Joseph to a slave trader. What a mess. This family was in shambles and everyone was contributing to the problems because everybody was selfish. Even if we could fix all of their problems, there is a far greater lesson for us to learn. We need to see the bigger picture of Joseph's story. In order to do that, we need to zoom out and begin to notice God's sovereignty surrounding the issues in Jacob's family. God's sovereign plans are always good. Nothing happens by accident. Joseph learned what it meant to trust God and to live for Him every step of his journey. His actions echo this truth. God is so great, I can trust Him and wait. Through faith, Joseph seemed to be anchored to an immovable God. Let's talk about the two traps that Joseph avoided because he waited on God. First, he did not blame God. With all the things that are happening around him, never did he blame God or ask God, "Where are you now?" He had no idea what God was doing in his life, but his faith helped him to trust God despite the troubles. Lastly, he fought fear and worry. Amazingly, Joseph was able to live out the truth in Psalms 37, verse 7, which says, "Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for Him." He waited in faith for God to turn the page of his story and to show him what was going to be in the next chapter. Do the situations in your life ever turn out differently than you had expected? Has God ever written an unexpected twist and turns into the story of your life like He did with Joseph? I'm sure He has. God is in control or sovereign. He is the author. We are just the characters in the story. We may not understand why we are hurting at a certain time. He wants us to be able to trust Him and say, God is so great. I can trust Him and wait. Do we need to understand why God is allowing us to experience hurts and struggles? No, of course not. Because if we believe that He is sovereign and good, then we can know that He has not forgotten us. Patient faith will free us to be able to say, God is so great, I can trust in Him and wait. Our feelings will fight us against this choice. It is part of our nature to want to be in control. We must choose to trust God, even if we can't see what He's doing. Young people, tonight, will you commit yourselves to Him and to His plan and promise to wait on what He's doing? Guys, it was great to have this time with you tonight, and I look forward to our next time. God bless you and stay safe.